sit your ass down. And
sit your ass down. Sit your $5 ass down before I make 10.
Man, sit your ass down.
Yes! Yes, this is something that we don't take, you know, we take very seriously over here. The Just Talk with Sam podcast, Sam Show Nation as a whole. Every week, we like to acknowledge those people who got lost their own sauce, start doing too much, trying to look like something they ain't, trying to look like something they are. They went a little too hard in the paint. These are this week's Sit Your Ass Down. Now, the Sit Your Ass Down acknowledgement is not an award. I want to make that plain. This is not an award. This is not an achievement. This is an acknowledgement for you doing too much. You need to chill. You need to reevaluate. And most importantly, take the time to sit your ass down. First, sit your ass down. We did a lot of wrestling talk today. First, go to my man, Hulk Hogan. Yes, Hulk Hogan. We talked about Banner today. We talked about Sid. We talked about a lot of cool stuff today. But Hulk Hogan mistakenly tweeted about Bam Margera being dead. And then Twitter was in an uproar. My man came out with the tweet. Talking about the jackass star, talking about some damn Bam. I wish he was still with us. You know, he was, he put a photo of him and himself with Bam Margera together. And the quote said, "I would love to hang out again, brother." See, here's a problem with that sit your ass down. Why he needs to sit his ass down. Bam Margera is still alive. Yes, Bam Margera responded to the tweet like, "Dude, what the fuck?" What Hulk Hogan meant to put was Ryan Dunn, the late Ryan Dunn, who passed away. It was on the anniversary of his death. See, the deal is, Hogan still put up a picture of him and Bam Margera. So, some tells me that Hulk Hogan and Bam Margera, Ryan Dunn, was really close. They real close friends, you know? Because you would know that shit. So, Hogan, I'm not wearing spandex, but in regular-ass clothes, let me tell you something. Sit your ass down. The next sit your ass down comes, at no surprise, I've gotten a lot of tweets, a couple emails, some Facebook messages about this one. Yes. Melania Trump. Now, we all know that there's a lot of controversy going on about the kids being separated from their parents at the border and this, that, and the third. And it's a lot. Because her husband, who for some reason is the president, got in the White House. His immigration policies just... He signed the shit on some shit he created, but that's a whole other subject. First Lady Melania was like, "Let me get down to the border." And she was rocking that Zara jacket with the slogan, "I really don't care, do you?" Now, here's the problem with that. The whole point... Let me take back the lens. The whole point of this presidency, if for nothing else, it ain't been about policy, it ain't been about... It's been about optics. It's been about looking a certain way. Not necessarily doing the right thing for certain people. It's about looking like you're doing the right thing for certain people. So why in the bluest of all hells? Now, I don't get it twisted. It's a smooth jacket. And Zara makes a lot of jackets and t-shirts with statements and little slogans like, "People are people. We should all be feminists. I am an immigrant." Yet, you know why you're there. The real reason you there is to show a face to say, "Hey, look, we care. The United States care. We ain't trying to separate no kids from no families. This and that and the third. I don't care what your politics are." Man, it's a bad look to have on that jacket. a jacket that second you say in their face, hey, I'm here to help, yada yada splee, first lady, we care about you, we want America great again, whatever you saying. Then you turn around and the only slogan they say is, I really don't care. The whole point of you being there is because you do care. So, Melania, take that jacket off and sit your ass down. And lastly, and certainly not leastly, this hurts. You ever had to sit your ass down with a person you like? And I like this person. And it bothers me that I got to do this. Because she was... Next sit your ass down, go to Keisha Knight Pullman, better known as Rudy from the Cosby Show. Yes, this is not about Cosby. This has absolutely nothing to do with William H. Cosby. But Keisha Knight Pullman did that thing that a lot of people are doing. You know, over 40. You think you got a budding rap career. And she put out a diss track to her ex. Granted, in the lyrics, you can Google it. She dragged her ex-husband, Ed Hartwell, in a rap song. She goes by, her rap name is Peaches. All right, for starters, here we go. She throws bars at her baby daddy, talking about some, you know, whatever they going through. She took a shot at Donald Trump, talking about the wig piece, talking about his hair, and then... talking about something she knew she got a prenup. Keisha. For starters, this is like a multi-layer sit your ass down. Going after Donald Trump for a rapper. All right, let me start here. As a rapper, your street name shouldn't be Peaches. Peaches is probably one of the most unoffensive names, or just not even shocking. When I think of Peaches, I think of something good, wholesome. I think of somebody who just, I want to just hang out with Peaches. You can't be throwing that hot fire, Peaches. There was actually an artist named Peaches who was a shock artist, but the fact that she was named Peaches is because people came out, yeah, the boys want to be her. Yeah, she made that song. But the whole point of her name being Peaches was the fact that it was so unoffensive she could say offensive shit. So, best case scenario, Keisha, your name is stolen. Best case scenario. Second off, taking jabs at Donald Trump right now is low-hanging fruit. So just, and yeah, you got beef. All right, third thing, you got beef with your ex. Come on now. You ain't got to do it in the form of rap. You would get a lot more supporters if you didn't spit that hot fire. And fourth and final, Rudy, I'll just call you Rudy at this point because I can't stop you from calling you Rudy. Rudy, Keisha Knight Pullman, you Rudy. You're going to be Rudy for the rest of your life. Rudy, just because, we talked about this earlier in the podcast, people over 40 is coming back rapping. I talked about last week, Will Smith, you got Nas, Jay-Z, Kanye's over 40. Yeah, Kanye's over 40. Black Thought. A lot of other people over 40. Does it mean... these are people who have rap careers already. You don't start at 40. At 40, you show you still got it. You ain't... this ain't the demo to get started. No. Mm-mm. So, Keisha Knight Pullman, a.k.a. Rudy. And it hurts me to say this because for a lot of reasons. Please sit your ass down.